So, I kind of hate to be the one that has to kind of spill a lot of the tea on the Trolls franchise. And don't get me wrong, I feel like I have to be the person to present the bad with the good. I mean, if I didn't do this, honestly, the transparency of Trollstopia probably wouldn't have happened. I mean, just look at what I did that told you guys to do with that Peacock video. Look what happened. Peacock was transparent with at least one person, and then a couple days later, we got the trailer. So, in a sense, it's kind of a good thing to talk about these things because if we don't address these things will get messy, and that's kind of this video. But there's a way to kind of solve the messiness of it all. Now, I won't be counting Cleo in space because technically that's the first Peacock and I think Hulu show. I'm not sure if Cleo's on Hulu, but in terms of something based on an old thing or a current thing, Madagascar A Little Wild is the first show to come out with the Peacock and Hulu merger. And this was the first show kind of out the gate. Ready to announce, but no trailer. We got a theme song and a promo picture, but that's about it. When it came down to the actual show and it get releasing, like clips just kind of dropped whenever it felt like it, and it was kind of hard to even remotely know because the Peacock Kids YouTube channel and I think like Hulu Kids or something. They post a lot of content on the daily, so of course you're probably gonna miss something. So the promotion wasn't that great. And then you get when it actually came out, it was like, oh, hey, by the way, it's out now, I guess. And there was only six episodes, which this is a little one show, like Go Go Corey Carson on Netflix had. I would say roughly about the same episodes. I think there was maybe eight episodes. But that was kind of like a red flag for me, even though it's kind of a norm for these little one shows. But at the same time, I think that's risky for this show, given the fact that it is new. Not to mention, it's a promising show. It's just that I think that if there was more under its belt, it could have definitely garnered an audience. But with six episodes, you could kind of forget you even watched the show in the first place. So that's definitely kind of like the risky thing about the six episode thing. After the show came out, there was like little to no promotion. And this is kind of familiar with Trollstopia goes on in terms of social media. It's like, here's the trailer. Here's like two clips we'll post. And here's the post about watch it this weekend or whatever. And then that's it. And that's what happened to Madagascar A Little Wild. And it also doesn't help that the show, just like Beat Goes On, had music. And with all six episodes, seven, if you want to count the Halloween special as part of the season. We still haven't gotten a soundtrack. A lot of the episodes on like YouTube or whatever, they haven't uploaded the music video parts, which that's been a huge issue I've been talking about with Trolls the Beat Goes On. And on Friday, they randomly just kind of shadow dropped a season two's happening on Peacock Kids, and then like they just kind of left. And they didn't announce it on their social medias at all. They just kind of dropped it on the Peacock Kids app, right next to the Trollstopia trailer, and then gave up. So this show is definitely a big red flag, and that definitely has me worried for Trolls. Now, Trolls is a different boat and situation, but it's not like they can't screw it over like they're doing Madagascar a Little Wild. Madagascar a Little Wild semi screwed over. It's bad. There's some pros in there, like the seasonal gaps. And the fact that we got a Halloween special, but even then, there's a lot of messiness with Madagascar a Little Wild, so don't be shocked if that's Trollstopia's future is just nothing more than both Hulu and Peacock being just incredibly bad with handling this show, so don't be shocked if this is gonna happen. So, with the recent trailer, everyone's kind of warmed up and fell in love with these new troll delegates that represent each world tour tribe, which is amazing. And I'm glad we got to have this. I will say this though, Peacock and Hulu could have done a better job. And more than likely, these characters probably wouldn't have faced a lot of drama if they just dropped this trailer earlier and allowed the cast and crew to kind of explain themselves and be like, hey, this is what's going on. Hope you guys enjoy when Trollstopia comes out, but that did not happen, and Peacock and Hulu waited last minute. The one thing I do want to present here is Tiny Diamond is in the cast, and that's kind of a no-brainer because Guy Diamond is part of the Snack Pack, but that's a start. That's a pretty good start. And I want to present this. This past week, Trolls turned 4 years, okay? You guys waited during Trolls Holiday, 8 seasons of Beat Goes On, and Trolls World Tour. You guys waited 4 years for Broppy to get confirmed. If you guys can wait 4 years for a ship to get confirmed, I'm pretty sure you guys can wait for Trollstopia to take its time and throw in World Tour characters when they want to. I'm pretty sure you guys can patiently wait for something like that. And Tiny Diamond is kind of the biggest hope we have of that. Tiny Diamond's in the cast, so that means later down along the lines, if we're patient, we will receive World Tour characters. So I want you all to keep that in mind. Because a lot of us are Trolls the Beat Goes On veterans and have been following Trolls social media since 2016, we pretty much know the song and dance of how Trollstopia is going to be marketed. And seeing as how Peacock and Hulu are pretty much doing the same thing Netflix did, really, it's no surprise. This is what we're gonna get, and we already got. So we got our trailer. They're gonna randomly drop some clips. Some are gonna be shadow dropped on the YouTube channel. Some of them are gonna be dropped on their social medias. They're gonna make a few posts going, oh, countdown till when the season premiere starts. After that, they're gonna make a post saying, hey, Trollstopia, it's here, watch it now. And then after that, they're not going to care. They're not going to do literally anything. And one thing I want to present, they don't even do birthdays for the Beat Goes On cast, which is pretty depressing. Like, they do it for the movies, but they don't do it for the shows. Which, I think they probably should, address the voice cast of these TV shows. But that's all they're gonna do. They're like, right when this gets done and over with, they're just gonna go right back to posting Trolls World Tour content, Trolls 2016 content, and then maybe merchandise or something. I don't really know, but they're not gonna do much. They're gonna be doing the same thing they did for the Beat Goes On era. And the sad part, freaking Universal Kids is doing a better job marketing Beat Goes On than any of the social media accounts. That's depressing. Then another thing that kind of is screwing this show over is now Peacock doesn't have this, but Hulu does. Hulu has the Animaniacs reboot that comes out on the 20th. Trollstopia comes out on the 19th. Do you really expect, with how Beat Goes On was not talked about, do you really expect Trollstopia is really going to compete with Animaniacs of all things? Do you really think Trollstopia is going to be the talk of the town? I really don't think so. So here's my suggestion to everyone. Before we get into the 19th, I recommend like that Monday, I think. Hang on, I gotta pull up a calendar. So the 16th, I highly recommend from the 16th up until the 19th. Everyone just hashtag Trollstopia like crazy on whatever social medias you have. I have Twitter, so I know I'm going to be hashtagging Trollstopia like crazy throughout that week. I highly recommend starting the hashtag around the morning time, no matter what social medias you have. During the mornings, like nothing big really happens, so anything fandom related is going to get noticed pretty quickly. So from the morning, start hashtagging Trollstopia, even throughout like any hour, but definitely try to start in the morning. Anyone with any person in the Trolls fandom who has a social media account, that's like from Twitter, Facebook, and I know the Trolls fandom is pretty big on Instagram, so definitely do that. I know the fandom's pretty big on Tumblr, so if anyone wants to hashtag Trollstopia, there, start doing that. Make any post you can possible, and hopefully that can get people to kind of go, oh, why is this Trollstopia thing trending? And if it doesn't trend, that's a-okay because we the fandom did a lot more than what Peacock and Hulu can say they probably will ever do to promote this show. So that's kind of my recommendation is just word of mouth, word of mouth, word of mouth, because Peacock and Hulu just aren't gonna do that, and that's pretty depressing, but that's just the state of the Trolls fandom and this franchise.